Hey everyone, and welcome to part one of our Let's Play Dragon Quest X. What you're seeing right now is the very first thing you will do in Dragon Quest X, which is to make your character. And as you can see, I'm just blasting through this because it's a complete joke. You just select the different, different settings there. And you just go through, and that's the last one. It's the only one where you have to name your character. Here you have to select if it's a brother, sister, things like that. Younger or older, brother or sister. And then again, you go through and customize all the different features. And like I said, you can figure this out. It's like pretty much idiot-proof. You shouldn't have any problems whatsoever here. So you'll easily be able to select your character, name it whatever you want, and we will begin this game. And here we go. Alright, now I can actually speak with you guys while I play. Isn't that amazing? Alright, so yeah, I lowered the volume because it defaults to crazy loud for some weird reason. So, let us play Dragon Quest X. Alright, so basically, just let's get a few things out of the way right away. I'm playing the game in 1080p at a glorious 60 frames per second. I am using Fraps to record all this action here. And yeah, so that's pretty much it. So this is the best possible resolution you can get in this game, playing the PC version, obviously. And we are going to start. So we're going to start by talking to this mofo right here. And I'm going to do it again. I'm going to actually say yes. And then he looks like he gets mad. I have no idea why. Now, first things, there's a couple things I want to mention. I am not fluent in Japanese. And in fact, I have not practiced Japanese in a very long time. So the truth of the matter is, I am going to be stumbling, I'm going to be falling, I'm going to be collapsing. You guys, if you do speak Japanese, pretty much going to laugh at me going, oh, that stupid gaijin. But yeah, that's going to happen. I'm pretty much going to get lost, and I'm going to have to follow translation guides that are online. Because, well, yeah, that's pretty much what I'm going to have to do because I don't know what the hell I'm doing. So this I've already done a couple of times. The very first thing that you want to do is you want to come to the back here, go into the church and talk to the guy that's on the far right-hand side. But before I do that, I'm going to just go and explore a little bit. Now, if you know the channel, then you know I actually did a full walkthrough of the beta, a little bit of a Let's Play. But this time around, this is not going to be a walkthrough. This is simply for those that are curious to see more Dragon Quest X. That's what this Let's Play is about. This is not a Let's Play to basically show you guys, oh, this is where you go and this is what you do, because we're going to be stumbling. There's going to be a lot of collapsing here because I really don't know what to do. And so that's what's going to be cool with this, is we're going to discover this stuff on our own. Well, not our own, but together we're going to sort of stumble, fall, collapse. And I think it's going to be fun. So I hope you guys enjoy this Let's Play. Because, well, it's going to be a unique Let's Play. I can't promise you I'm going to have time to do episodes every 2 seconds and things like that. But I will try and get these out in a semi-regular basis. As I play the game, I'm going to record. Now, I'm also going to be recording my buddy Scott when I get to the online portion. So, at least hopefully he can sort of like power grind us if he can. Alright, so anyways, so you start off by talking to this guy. Here's the map, this is where you go, and when you basically talk to him, and what he's going to want is two items, and those two items are actually located in the section of the town we were just in. What I love about this, I play with a controller, and if you press the left bumper, you auto-run. Glorious! It's actually brilliant. Really, really like this. I love this game. I'm so mad that this game is not available in North America. And now, especially, it's looking like it will never be made in North America. And that sucks. Because it's a really fun MMORPG. And it would be the perfect MMORPG for a guy like Steven, my friend, who helps on the channel here. But, like I say, I don't think this is ever going to happen. And it's really, really unfortunate. Alright, so, like I said, I don't know what we're doing, okay? I know how to do this section, so I'll definitely be able to walk through this, but when we get to the online section, I'm probably going to read ahead a little bit, just so that I know more or less what's coming, so that, you know, we're not spending half an hour of you seeing me stumble all over the place, because that really wouldn't be fun for anybody. Okay. I believe it's in the back here. We gotta talk to this lady. Let's move the camera. There you go. Alright, you hear that sound? That's the sound you want to hear. Because essentially, we're good to go. Oops, I didn't check these. Nice. Can sell almost all of this junk. Because everything you do here does not save. It's basically a giant tutorial. I don't know why I'm talking to this guy again, because I need to go over here. And I'm probably going to have to move the mic a bit, so I hope you guys can hear me, because I'm going blind staring at this big screen. Alright, so then, talk to her. And there you go. So we got our two items that we needed. At least I believe it's items. I'm going to go over here. And whenever there's a cutscene, guys, I'm going to shut up, I'm going to mute the mic, and that's the way we're going to go. And if you find that the volume of the game is too loud, do keep in mind, like I said, I'm using Fraps, so I can only adjust that once. So hopefully this turns out, and I'll go accordingly. Now, I think I missed a treasure chest somewhere, but whatever, I'm trying to blast through this portion. Because to be honest, the offline portion, I don't really care too much about. I'm much more interested in the online portion. Because once my friend gets online, we'll be able to do a lot of power grinding. And it's going to be awesome, because we'll be able to quickly go through all of this. Alright, so we're gonna go back, we're gonna see that dude, a little cutscene's gonna play out, and then we will be able to be on our way to something glorious. Alright, here we go, so I'm gonna shut up now. Okay, I was mistaken. It's after you go in here. Alright, here's the cutscene. Alright, so now we're going to basically go and find my little brother. So I always search everywhere. Ooh, we got some equipment. Okay, so I never went over this. This is the talk command, which is totally useless. This command right here is for your items. This command is how you, equip items. And if you press the right bumper, you can zoom in. You press select and start to go around. I don't know why you can't actually see the earrings here. It's bizarre. But, what else do we got? This one is, it's telling you your stats. There's my name at the top right. Anoa says level 1. And how much gold I've got. This is magic. This, I forget, I think it's like a quest info. I don't recall what that is. And this is where you go into your settings. That one is if you want to heal yourself. And this one is to move the camera around if you want to invert it. This one is for your background music. You can see I have it at 2 because any louder you won't even be able to hear me. And that's to quit the game, so no, not gonna do that. All right, yeah, and let's see what else. I just did a pause there because my significant other came home. So I'm gonna just save quickly and then we'll be on our way. So to save is really simple. You just press the first option up there and say yes. And you get the classic animation here with the classic music. Well, animation, classic music. And then it's gonna ask you, would you like to continue the game? And of course, I'm going to say yes and we are gonna keep going. Alright, we're gonna continue now, believe it or not, but I did step away when the missus came around and went and had dinner and whatnot. and I checked out all the footage that I captured, and well, I made some startling discoveries, one of which is that by recording at the frame rate and the resolution I was in Fraps, just like 12 minutes or so took up like almost 80 gigabytes, so I was like, whoa, so what I'm gonna do is I'm basically gonna keep the FPS the same, but I'm gonna lower the resolution to 720 in the game, and then upscale it to 1080, so it won't be 100% perfect. But I just, if we want to have like a good Let's Play, there's no way I'm gonna be able to have, you know, say like 12 terabytes just to get one video out. It's gonna take a dog's age to do. I've also adjusted the volume, as you can see here. I put it to 3 because I found 2, the volume in the background was just a little bit too low. So hopefully this is going to be okay for you guys. I also watched the video and it turned out pretty good from right now. So I explained what all of this does and we're on our way. And I just want to reiterate yet again that, you know, I do not speak Japanese. So you're getting a real North American point of view here. And like I said before, I'm going to try and sort of watch ahead, read ahead, look at some guides, and go from there. And yeah, and that's pretty much the gist of it. So right now, what we're trying to do, if I go on the map, we are attempting... Oh, those are stores and stuff. No, where is it? These are, I forget what this is, that's your active quest, I think it is. Anyways, what we're trying to do right now is we are trying to locate my little brother in the game, and I know exactly where he is. Now, you notice right now, you see the way things are popping in the background, see that? Yeah, that happens, and, you know, this is not the most stunning video game ever created. But it's good. I mean, I really like it. It's got an amazing draw distance. You'll see in a sec, because it's the first time we're going outside. See? Look at that. That's quite nice. All right. We were level 1. So till we've got 6 points to our next level. So we're going to go ahead and just fight everything we possibly can. I believe I have a sword. I sure hope. I didn't actually check that. Yeah, I do. Phew. Oh. I'm gonna get attacked here a bunch of times, but this is attack, this is for magic, this is to use your items, and this is if you need to like equip stuff. So anyway, let's beat this guy. Should get 2 turns consecutively because I've been waiting. Now there's a strategy here. See the way I'm pushing the enemy? That comes in handy when you're fighting stronger enemies to protect like your healer and things like that. So you'll get good at that. You'll see that when Scott joins the game. Now for this Let's Play, what I would really like to do, I don't know if we're gonna get a chance to finish, say, the entire offline portion, of which I wanted to mention there are 2 offline portions. There's this section, like, I don't know what we call it. I guess like section A, where you go through this giant tutorial. And then the next section is actually an advanced offline mode. I might do that later on, but for right now, what I really want to do is get online so that Scott can join us. He's level 40, and we can just do some power grinding, and I can start taking on some quests and going from there. And like I said already at the beginning of this Let's Play, this first episode here, do not expect me to show you guys where we have to go. Like, you really should not be using this as a walkthrough. I really wanted to do this just because I want to play the game. So I know there's going to be some episodes where we're doing nothing but grinding. And there's going to be episodes where we're doing nothing but trying to figure out sort of where we have to go with probably like a really broken English... called like strategy guide or something like that. So I hope you guys are cool with that. I know I've repeated myself like a dozen times, but still, it's important. Okay, see what happened here? We've got a nice little treasure chest. Well, open it up, and oh, and I got attacked, which means I'm probably gonna lose that chest, son. Oh no, it's there. Hey, awesome. Anyways, yeah, that happens from time to time where you'll get a treasure chest, so it's pretty cool. And I haven't leveled yet. Been talking to you guys and playing, I haven't even been paying attention, but yeah, it doesn't look like I leveled. And you don't really need to be far. I finished this, I went to the cave, which is where we gotta go, which I'm gonna show you in just a second when I beat this guy. I think I'm gonna hit level 2 right now, actually. Here we go. So there you go, your stats are all increased. Woohoo! Later on, you get to allocate points. But again, this is strictly a tutorial, so it's nothing fancy. Just, there we go, healing myself. And how much money do we have? 42. Ugh, it's pathetic. This is, it's amazing game, guys. It really is. And you'll see when we get online and we start having some fun with the online mode, that's when it gets so much more interesting. Because a full-fledged MMO, and I will never, ever, even if we get 500 episodes in, I'll never be, you know, perfect at this, because, like, we couldn't really tackle too much unless we get an all-English team. There's not much I'm going to be able to do. Like, I could complete the story on my own, because you can hire helpers if you watch my beta videos. And even if I do, like, team up with some other players eventually, like, I'll be able to do some damage. But overall, you know the way it is. It's in a foreign language, so I'll never truly get the maximum out of this game. And that's kind of unfortunate, because it'd be really amazing to just have this in English and, you know, really experience absolutely everything, because I know what's going to end up happening. I'm going to do a whole bunch of videos. I'm going to, like, you know, really get far, have fun, probably hit, like, max level. And then, maybe if the game, if we ever get lucky and the game is released outside Japan, what's going to end up happening is I'm going to end up laughing, because I'll be like, oh my goodness, I didn't realize I could do, you know, this, that, and the other thing, and that would be just hysterical. I'm pretty sure I'm going to have to break this video up into a couple of parts. I haven't decided yet if I'm actually going to, like, sign off. I'm probably not. I think I'm just going to cut the videos to, like, half an hour each or something like that. And wherever we are. And then I'll just continue with the next episode just directly where we left off. And I don't think I'm going to label these episodes per se. I think I'm just going to say, like, episode 1, episode 2, things like that. Just because, for the most part, at least initially, until we know what the hell we're doing, it's going to be a lot of grinding and, you know, just getting things sort of on track. I can't wait, though, to get to the online portion so that we can pick the same character I was last time. And I know it's going to be a little bit boring for those that did follow the original playthroughs I did, but I'm doing that on purpose because I'm comfortable with those characters, and I always wanted to, not characters, but character, and I always wanted to, like, do more, and I just couldn't because I didn't have the full game, and I couldn't buy the full game back then. I could have bought the game, but it only came with 20 days of free access, and I was like, well, yeah, but if I can't pay the monthly fee, what the hell's the point? But now I can, so this is awesome. Like, I can go really far in this game, and I plan to do just that. So it's going to be great to get back into the groove of things, and it will take me time, for sure. It's going to take lots of time for me to figure out, you know, where I have to go, making sure that I pick the right character, because I want to be a monk again. I had a really good time with the double-fisted weapons, and yeah, so we'll see what happens with that. I can't wait to get back into crafting, because I was a blacksmith before, and it was great being able to build my own weapons. And hopefully I'll be able to get some cash from selling them on the marketplace. I'm going like that. I'm really looking forward to that. I can't believe I actually went in the complete wrong direction. And I know, guys, this is not the most exciting, but, that's the beauty of Let's Plays. Hopefully you don't find me too annoying. Anyways, here's the map. And that's the village. Yeah, and that's the only thing we have access to. Is this guy still gonna... Yeah, I see, I'm still too low level. When you see them, when they're chasing you like that, that means that they're very hostile towards you because you're low level. When they start ignoring you, that's when you're pretty much like, okay, well, I'm about equal level, so it's not the end of the world. Like, if I go too much further, I'm gonna have a really, really hard time. like, you know, one hit sort of deal is going to do significant amount of damage, and I won't be doing very much damage back to them. So if I keep going after these little guys, I should be good. Woo! And I keep going back, see? Oh, well, that changes things. Okay, level 3. How many of these do we have? Well, we have 7. Hell, let's use it. Yeah. Heal, baby. Woo! Herb. Alright. And we're not going to the right, because that's like instant death, if I remember. We're going straight up. Now, I'm not sure. You know what? Let's play this safe. Let's go right here and get this little guy. And I don't remember the names of any of these guys, because I haven't played a Dragon Quest in a long time now. Oh, we're level 3. Have we unlocked heal yet? Just want to take a look. Yeah, we have. Kick ass. Okay. Ooh, raising tension. I gotta kill this guy. There we go. And if you've ever played a Dragon Quest before, you know the way this works. You fight some slightly stronger enemies than you in order to level yourself up as quick as possible, but without, you know, being too dangerous. Like, I gotta be careful, because these guys are not exactly weak. Oh, and you know what? I'm being stupid. I just thought of something. I lied to you guys. I lied! I said I didn't have to go to the side there, right? Well, I do. Up above is where it is where you go to progress the story later on. So I made a little bit of a boo-boo. I do have to go. My brother is hiding off right there. Now, by the way, you'll find stuff like this all over the place when you get online. I'm going to stop referring to the beta, I think, because I want you guys to just, you know, start watching from here. Okay. My health, I'm a big weenie when it comes to Dragon Quest. Like to be prepared, because, you know, we don't want to die. So we got to fight this guy before we gain access into the area, and we should be able to down him fairly quickly. Not too concerned about this. We got this. Oh yeah, we really got this. I wonder if you can hear me clicking away on the controller. That'd be kind of funny. And trust me, it gets a lot more interesting when you can hire your own team or bring your own friends in. It's way, way more interesting. And I will tell you right now, spoiler alert, there's no point in keeping any of this crap. Sell it all, because when you do get to the online portion, you're going to be making an entirely new character. Ooh, cinematic time! Alright, what happened here is this little boy just joined us. So Nono joined Anoa. So that's pretty awesome. And by the way, I made a mistake last time. I told you that this setting right here was to close the game. That's actually full of crap. It's the setting you use for your headpieces if you want to hide them. And the reason why they added that is because of this. Ew, that's disgusting. Look at that. Yuck. That's so gross. Ew. So what you can do, you can go down here, go down here, go down here, and say, yes, hide it. But I'm going to, I'm going to keep it on. Why not? Just to be goofy. You like being goofy. We all like being goofy. All right, now, you might want to go ahead and continue leveling, but there's no real point because we are going to get a third character in our party, like, pretty much immediately. So I never even bother. So what I'm going to do instead is look at how much gold. 88 gold. Ugh, I don't even have enough. You know what? Let's fight one of these guys only because I need, I think it's 90 for a new sword or 140. Should have checked, actually, prior to leaving. Oh, well, whatever. So now my brother is right there, and he's going to keep whacking. Well, I actually don't know why he keeps whacking. I think he's a healer, if I recall correctly. Now, did he get 90? Yeah. All right, anyways, he'll heal us, and if he whacks on the enemies with, I don't even know what he has, a wand or whatever, then he can replace his MP, which is fantastic, so that he can keep basically healing us, which is exactly what we're going to need when we go up against the boss, which will be coming up relatively soon. All right, so where are we? We got to go back to the church and trigger another cinematic, but since we're right here, actually, let's jump for joy. Woo! Let's just find out. Some other settings for you here. This is to buy, that is to sell. So, for example, these are your items. You can sell items or you can sell weapons and armor. And I'm going to sell these. Yes, because I don't need to sell anything else, but I would like to purchase. And the sword is 150. Son of a mother. He's got me. Beep, beep, beep. I'm really close. I'm not going to bother. We'll come back. Yeah, I don't know why there's popping. I don't know if that was in the beta or not. I'll have to check my old videos out. I got a much better microphone this time around, although, what's called Fraps, I find the quality of the recording of the audio is not that hot. Usually I use Audacity for my reviews, and I like it because it's free, is number one, and number two, I like it because it's got really good bitrate, really good quality, but for Fraps, I don't know, I checked the settings, and maybe I'm doing something wrong, because I find that the microphone settings are kind of crappy, my voice doesn't come out too great. Alright, so we'll talk, and it's not him, it's the lady. Alright, here we go. Cutscene again. Thank you. Man, isn't Toriyama's art just the best? I love it. Anyway, so we got our third party member. I'm gonna save just quick, because you never know what happens, and I know that today there is scheduled maintenance for the online portion. Now, I'm not sure if that's gonna actually affect this offline portion or not, but I don't want to take the chance. Yes, I want to continue playing. I'll talk more about the priests later on in terms of what they do for you, how they can cure different status ailments and things like that, but we'll cover that later on. When we get to Glen, which is the ogre's main city, whatever, that one we're gonna, that's where like I'll probably do like a whole sort of like episode on some of the different features, where you can go, what you can do, and things like that. When we do finish this offline portion, that's where like I'll talk a little bit about the different races and you know, whatever, we'll go from there. But I am gonna be an ogre pretty much right away, because I want to be, because like I said, I had a lot of fun with that last character, and I don't want to have to start over with something new. At least with that, I have a reference. It's a good starting point. I know some of you might say, oh, that's just lazy or whatever, but I want to make this as fun for myself as it is to like to play, as it is to watch. So if we're struggling right away from the opening scenes, that's not exactly going to be, you know, the most fun thing to watch. But anyways, we'll see. But I definitely am going to be an ogre again. I'm going to be a monk again. All I got to do is get to level 20. Once I'm at level 20, I can switch the classes up. It's no big deal. But, yeah, I'm going to be a monk for sure. And then we'll see. Could be a warrior or something like that later on. And all it is to allocate points to different skill sets that you have. And that's where I've got to do some research, because I really don't remember which one's strengths, which one's HP, which one's, you know, like all those different things. So we're definitely going to do that, but we'll cover that much later on when we get there. Okay, I'm going to be really ballsy here, because I'm level 3, yeah, no, never mind. I'm going to keep attacking these guys until they don't do that anymore, until they don't auto-attack me. Oh, and I should not be attacking the little rabbits. Now, you see, I can push this guy because he's the one I gotta worry about. Everybody taking off one I could care less about. But this guy, I gotta worry. I gotta watch him. Because if he does land a critical blow on, say, like, the healer, my little brother there, who is gonna remain at level 3, I might add. There we go. Nice. Come on. Yeah, I really don't remember. I'd have to go and watch the beta to see, but I could have sworn that your other characters leveled before, but I could be totally wrong. I haven't played the beta in over a year, so I don't recall. But I know that right now they do not level, so the other two characters are just, they're going to stay at the levels they are, so it's going to... Ooh, you see what I mean? Look at that. Ow. That hurt. So they're going to stay at level 7, level 3, and I know that I went into the dungeon when I was level 7. And I was able to kill the golem at that point in time. Oh, is this a mimic? This might be a mimic. Where's Nodo? Oh, nice. I didn't even pay attention to what that was. Well, that was interesting. I guess he was too close to the rock. It didn't trigger. So between this and Dragon Quest VII on the 3DS, boy, I've got a lot of Dragon Questing going on now. Hey, get away from him! Get away! You see what they did there? That was cool. I got pinned and I couldn't attack the other character. I'm gonna do this till, I think level 5. We'll do it till level 5. And then I will go and I'll... Oh, there we go. Then I'll go and attack that little guy there, Slime Knight. Ooh, there's more. more goodies over here. Sweet! What do we got? Good, more selling garbage. Because I will go back to town one more time before I go and take on the cave.
The Cave of Doom.
But I think if I hit level 5, I think it should be more than enough to tackle this slime. I might actually try him right now, but I should hit at least level 4. Come on, give me level 4. Only two more necessary. Good. So I'll ding right now, as they say, or I'll level right now. Don't mind me, I sing in my playthroughs, so you'll have to excuse me. If you don't like it, well, sorry. I really need a new weapon. I was so weak against the boss, it was crazy. There we go. In the last game that I played, it was crazy. I got pretty much destroyed because I couldn't even hit him. I was so weak. All right, here we go. Let's see if this is feasible. If I don't get destroyed here, then we can move on to the next level and we can level. I think I'm going to be okay. Yeah, I'm going to be fine. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to move on to the next section. There's another section prior to the... Oh, but look, I think I'm gonna go get that sword. Okay, wait a sec. I got 6 points, 177 gold. Alright, let's max this out right away. You'll see where we're at. And I love the fact that the map has a grid to it. Look, you'll see A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I like that. Anyway, see that cave all the way at the top? Well, that's where we're going. But we're not going there yet. We still got, like I said, we got at least 3 more levels to grind out prior to taking on the golem that that guards that surrounding area. I just want to see how many points I actually get for this, and then we'll see what's necessary. Okay, let's see, what do we got? How many points? 8 points, okay. And, okay, yeah, I only need 20 to hit 5, so we're going to do that. Let's do that. There'll only be a couple of battles. And then we'll head back, and I think that's where I'm going to end this first episode. But you may already be on episode 2, for all I know. Ooh, that's going to hurt. And later on, you can change the statistics of your party members in order to, you know, have them heal more, things like that. But I don't think that's going to be necessary for the bulk of this Let's Play. Only because I'm gonna have generic party members for the most time, and I'm gonna specifically get a healer, get a warrior, things like that. And I might even get another monk. I don't remember what I used to do. So we'll see. Okay, how much is that? Ooh, that's beautiful. Perfect. All right, excellent. So this is going to help me hit level 5. We'll see. I haven't figured out exactly how I'm going to label this. I'm wondering if I should say, like, offline level 1 to 5, something like that. Ooh, we all got a little bit screwed up there. Does anyone need it? Well, I'll give it to Nono. And I should... Perfect. Ah, crap, and I walked right into it. Run away! And if you want to run away, by the way, in battles, you simply run outside. There's like a little circle. You can't really see it, but there's a little circle. I'll show you here. And I know I said I was going to take off, but which I will. All right. Get out of the way. You see it? See it on the ground there? That's the basically the battle area. If you leave that, you forfeit or you run away or whatever you want. Let's fight a metal slime. Not a metal slime, a slime knight. You notice now they're not attracted to me. I'm not pulling aggro from them. So that's a good thing. It means that my level is about right for this area. And I think it is about right for this area. Two more levels and I should be good to go. I just don't really want to go all the way back to town just to come all the way back here and then go all the way back to town again. I'd rather actually, like, do what I can to hit level 7. And there we go. What do we need? 43. I need a couple more of these guys. Because they were giving 16 experience. That'd be glorious. Oh, that douchebag healed himself. Now, watch Nono. That's my little brother character. Check him out carefully, and you'll see that he's going to go and hit. And you see, when he does, he gets 1 MP. Now, I don't want to feed him any supplies to boost his MP, because we're going to need that for the boss. And since I can pretty much heal myself with herbs... Yeah, let's do that. And what are we at? 29. Perfect. Come on, guys. Take you both on! Alright, good. So two more battles and should be level 6. Well, two more. One more after this, and I don't really care. Oh my god, run away. So I'm getting stronger. If I had a better weapon, this would be, I'd be really all set. It'd be much, much easier, actually, because, and it would be a lot quicker. It's just like I said, I don't want to have to go back and forth a billion times. Don't you dare push me. How dare you! What are we getting? 14 now? Oh, that sucks. I gotta do two more. Unless I get two of these guys. Alright, nice. That'll be 16. And that should be good. Then we'll see how much money I have, because I didn't pay attention to that. You know, I should actually stand behind this guy. Oh, my poor little brother. He's gonna get raffle stomped. I was wondering if I should heal. Oh, I'm gonna heal him. I'm gonna heal you. And hopefully we level, and then we're gonna run back, because everyone's running low on MP. We can go to my little bed and go to sleep. Okay, that should be it. 16, 16, 16. Come on, come on, come on. Yeah. Alright, where the hell is the exit? Right there. I'm telling you, I love the ability you have to auto-run. It's genius. And this game really was made for a console. Yeah, it's great that you can type, but this is a console game. There's no question about it. It was perfectly designed with a controller in mind. Like, perfectly. It's just great. All right. Since we're here, I'll go get these two things again just so that I can sell them. And that'll be that. You notice there's a day-night system. as per usual, of the Dragon Quest games. And it's such a shame that this series just is not more popular outside of Japan. Because I would love to play this with all of you guys. And the price is really cheap. I mean, 90 days was... I think it was 2,000 yen for 90 days. I don't quote me on that at all. I've got to still do... well, as I'm recording this, I still have to do a video showing you guys how to actually purchase the game, but by the time you actually watch this, you will have already most likely seen that video. That's the way these things go. Because, well, that's just the way I'm filming them. I'm actually playing the game before I film how to actually go and buy the game, but it's really simple. So that video is going to be a really short one. All right, here we go. So we're back in town. Now, first thing I'm going to do is go and sell the useless crap I don't need. And I'm going to equip all my goodies. All right. I can technically sell everything. I'm not going to, but I'm going to sell these. Yes. Now I am going to purchase this right here. This lovely sword. Yes. Equip it. Yes. I will get this shield. Yes. Equip it. Yes. And now I have no more money, so I'm going to sell this. And I think that's all we got, right? Yeah. So I can't sell anything else, and I don't think I have enough money to buy anything, eh? No. Oh, so close. Two off for, like, some pants. Well, I don't even know if I need pants. I don't know if I need pants! Let's go. Where's my house? Yeah, the house is right here. Love the soundtrack to this series, too. It's amazing. Alright, there's my bed. All three of us sleeping together. We are very close together, apparently. Okay, and since we're in town, I know it's a pain in the ass, but we're gonna go and save. Now, when you get online, you do not need to do that. What you can do instead is you can go to a pub and log out through the pub. And what I like about that is that it allows you to rent yourself out to other Dragon Quest players. And that's cool because you can actually gain experience and whatnot while you're not even playing the game. And I love that. I think that's a genius move. And maybe this wasn't the first game to create that or do that, but whatever. I really, really like that. Okay. So we're gonna save this. And I'm gonna say yes, I will continue playing. But for you guys, this is it. Oh, twitching out. This is it for this walk. Well, see, I almost said walkthrough. This is it for this first episode of Let's Play. The next time we come back, what we're going to do is we're going to tackle a couple more levels, maybe get some more gear, and then we're going to go for that cave before wrapping up the offline portion of Dragon Quest X, or at least the quick part of the offline version of Dragon Quest X. And then we're going to go ahead and race towards the online portion. And that's where the real fun lies. Thanks everyone for joining, and I hope you look forward to more Dragon Quest X.